wind is going. We're throwing people around over here. Don't worry, this is all very safe, very controlled atmosphere for sure. Let's get to some other games as these guys are still throwing around over here with the players. How about just down the road in Chambersburg? Harrisburg making the trip down in a game that turned into
Chambersburg downright scary at home in a game that turned out to be a classic. First quarter, Michael Clark has time down the middle for Daquan Waters. Touchdown, 22 yards, Cougars go in front. The name is Jamal Pickett, and he had himself a night. Faking out everybody, including our cameraman. Where's he at? There he goes. 61-yard touchdown. He had 6 touchdowns in the game. Ties the game at 7. The defense stepping up at least momentarily for Chambersburg. Zane Stewart, the first man in on the sack. Try to get some momentum going. But later, handoff to Sheldon Snell. Breaking outside. Cuts it back, breaking ankles on his way to the end zone. Harrisburg would be trailing huge in this game, but they come all the way back in the second half and win 54-51 over Chambersburg. Back at Shippensburg, victory tonight over Northern, undefeated in the division, winners of 6 in a row, and now showing off their strength by just picking people up and moving them around. Big thank you to these guys for having us out tonight. Best of luck the rest of the way. We'll be back one more time with a hit from the band, but Hazzy, for now, back to you.
The old football mosh pit. There we go. Back to the LL League. Elko is only 2-5, but the Raiders have been one of the most exciting teams in the area. Twice this year, they scored 50 or more and lost. Tonight, they paid a visit to Columbia for a Section 3 clash. Elko moving the ball. Jeff Martin back to pass. Airs it out deep to Dustin Miller, who makes a diving catch for a big game. Later in that drive, the Raiders give it to Jake Steger, who goes around the left side, almost goes down, keeps his balance, and takes it in. Elko leading in the second half. Columbia then going for it on fourth down. They throw it deep where it is picked off by Derek Miller. Miller starts to bring it back, gets stopped, but he doesn't go down, so he keeps running. Picks up another 20 yards, and that turnover would set up another Raiders score. Cameron Strauss taking off, motoring 40 yards for the TD right up the middle. Elko goes on to down Columbia 29-14. Time now to check back with Pat Principe in Hanover.
The little pep band that could from Hanover High School serenading us here on Football Friday, giving us a little medley from the Lion King. All right, we got more York Adams football highlights for you. In Division I tonight, Dallas Town and Central York began play, tied for the league lead. Both teams 2-0 in division play, so the winner is going to have a leg up on a bid for a division title. Let's see how that game played out.
Central York leading Dallas Town 14-7 to start the second half. This game was a slobber knocker. Panthers drive, Braun Randall ricocheting off tacklers. That's about as tough of an 8-yard run as you're ever going to see. Sets up Kyle Smith from 30 yards for 3. Yes, and Central's lead is 10 at 17-7. Wildcats down to their last hope, fourth down, but they're going nowhere. The Panther defense tough all night. Central York wins 17-7. They are 3-0 in the league and in sole possession of the York Adams Division I lead. More from York Adams Division I. Spring Grove visiting York High. Rockets with the ball. Seth Hildebrand with the fake and then lets it fly. Logan Hall behind the defense. 50 yards. 7-0. Spring Grove breaks out on top. York will retaliate. James Way rolling and then stopping and lofting it up. Dakeem Dennison's got it. And we're deadlocked at 7 apiece. Still in the first quarter, Bearcats ball. It's Brayshon Sweeney going right and right into the end zone from a 15, and York is on top 14-7. Second quarter now, it's Hildebrand looking one way for Spring Grove, going the other to Shea Fulmer, touchdown, and we're deadlocked again at 14 apiece. Back come the Bearcats. It's Way rolling the other way and letting it fly, and this time it's Dennison with the grab and into the end zone for a 21-14 lead. The Bearcats win it 49-35 to square their record at 4-4. A hearty group of Hanover Nighthawk fans hanging with us here
at Shepherd Myers Stadium. We enjoyed our time here, our first ever Football Friday hosted by Hanover. All right, let's head back now to Lancaster. Mike Hostetler and Barbara Barr have more action for us.
Thank you, Prince. We continue in the LL League and another standout performance.
We saw one earlier and another one tonight. Penn Manor and Warwick. The Comets might try not to look past Warwick. Head to that Wilson showdown.
Big win against Wilson.
Senior night in Millersville for the Comets, and the defense set the tone early. Watch this play. Matt Pennypacker to Gabe Taylor. Look at the hit. Oh. Logan Kinster delivers, and Taylor actually held on to the ball.
Boom,
the Comets
dynamite.
Offense would strike early. Tanner Erisman to Brett Caggiano, cutting over the middle. 24 yards, looks like he's in, but called down at the one. Charlie Bell would take it in from there. Speaking of Mr. Bell, what a player from the shotgun. Skips through. Keeps his balance and goes 54 yards for the touchdown, answering the bell, of course. And that was just the beginning for him. It was 14-0 Comets as they're ready for their cruise. The fans, Warwick would respond, though. Pennypacker to Anthony Faggio, 53 yards, slashing across the middle. He would also be brought down at the one, but that would set up a Warrior touchdown. 14-6, it's a ball game until, of course, Bell strikes again out of the Wildcat. Direct snap, finds the hole, great blocking, 80 yards untouched. He had 5 touchdowns, 257 yards on Mike, just 8 carries. Penn Manor wins, 42-13, that's about 32 yards per carry.
For the season, Charlie Bell has 1,800 touchdowns, I just saw that.
Really?
We'll be right back. Stay with us.